you are learning Portuguese, I bet you have wondered how to get those pesky little accents to show up when you're typing on your computer. So easy when you know how, so annoying when you don't. So in today's video, I'm going to walk you through how to enable getting accents on your computer, whether you use Windows or Mac. Whether you are a regular here or brand new, welcome to Talk the Streets for another year of tips and tutorials about all things Portuguese, the kind from Portugal, mostly. How to get accents on your computer is one of the questions that I am asked the most, so let's dive right in with how to do that step by step, and stay tuned to the end because I'll be showing you how you can submit your burning questions about Portuguese to be answered on this very channel. Let's do it! So what we're going to take a look at then is how to do this on a Windows machine. So the first thing that we need to do is in that bottom left hand there where it says type here to search, we are going to search for language settings. So I can find it there. So once I'm in here, the first thing that I am going to do is go down where it says add language, because what we want to make sure is we have this English United States option here. So if I didn't have that already, I'd just click add language and I would find it there in this long list of languages. So because I already have it, I don't need to do that. So next thing, I'm going to click on that English United States and I'm going to click on options. So once we are inside the options, this is where we're going to actually find the international keyboard. So here I can click add keyboard, and what we want to find is this United States International. So I've already got it loaded up there, but if I didn't, I would click add keyboard and I would search for United States International. So once we have got that, that is the key to being able to do our accents, because down here at the bottom right, I can then toggle between the different languages that I have loaded up, okay? So I can actually put on ENG for just English, or I can click it and make it ENG International, okay? So that shows me that my options for using the international keyboard are going to work. So let's then see how we would actually use this then in a Word document. So we're now going to do a Word document, open one up. Here we go, just a nice simple Word document to show you that now we can actually use keyboard shortcuts to get the accents that we want. So for example, if I wanted to do the accent that goes shooting straight up, I would simply need to press the apostrophe key followed by the letter that I want to have that accent. So if it was E, I would type apostrophe E and it will come up. If I type apostrophe A, that will come up also. So this one's nice and straightforward. It also works the same way if you want the C cedilha, the one with the C with the little beard on it to make a S sound in Portuguese. So again, I would press apostrophe C and that will give me the C cedilha. So for the accent going in the opposite direction, the grave going downwards, this one I need to use the key under escape, at least that's what it was on my keyboard here when I was experimenting. So that character key under escape followed by the letter that I want is what is going to give me the downward accent, okay? So the last one that we are going to want to use then is the tilde, the squiggle, the worm above the A's and the O's when we need a nasal sound. This one is a bit trickier to do, and it probably will depend on your keyboard and your version of Windows. But for this one, I needed to use Shift Alt as well as that same key that I just used underneath escape to create the accent that we just did. So Shift Alt and the one underneath escape followed by the A is what gave me that tilde accent there. So you may need to play around with this a little bit and, you know, work out what works on your machine, but this should work if you've got this international keyboard activated, okay? So that is how we get our accents on Windows machines. Now, if you're using a Mac, it's much easier. You don't have to do any installing of keyboards or anything. All you're going to do is you're going to take the letter that you want to say with an accent over it. So for example, E, I'm going to hold it down
until I see these numbers appear. Now, these numbers correspond to the type of accent that I want. So say I want the accent that goes upwards, I am going to press 2 and it's going to give me an accent over that E. Same thing, if I wanted the C with Cedilia, I would hold it down, press 1 because that corresponds with the accent that I want, and there we go. So that is nice and easy. Another trick that you can do is if you are, doing your writing inside a Word document, what you can do is you can highlight that text, you can go over to Tools, Language, and set it to Portuguese, not Polish, Portuguese. And what that's going to then do for you is correct your spelling. So for example, if I wrote the word são, it's going to automatically give me that accent without me actually having to do it, okay? So you might see a red squiggle appear underneath if you haven't written something with an accent that it needs, and if you right click, it will simply correct it for you. Of course, I would rather you're putting them in there manually yourselves to be testing yourselves to remember where to put them, but that's also another double check that you can do.
So I hope that that was helpful and you are now ready to get those all important accents on your computer. Remember, they're not just helpful for telling us how to sound out the word, but also where the stress goes. Now, before I go, I want to know, is there a question that you have got about Portuguese? Something that you are desperate to find out but can't find the answer anywhere? Something that's really bugging you that I can help with? Let me help you. Grab your phone, record yourself asking the question, just like this, and save it to your camera roll. Then head to Instagram and post it on your stories and tag me at Talk the Streets. To make doubly sure that I see it, then send it to me via DM and I could be answering your question on this channel. I'm so excited to be starting up another year of answering your questions on Portuguese. So if 2022 is the year that you are finally going to nail Portuguese, make sure that you are subscribed so you never miss my weekly tips and tutorials. And click the bell as well to get notified every time there is new content. Until then, pessoal, tchau for now.